Fox 2 News at 9 a.m. This table setting guide is popping up everywhere online for the rather unique addition. According to this table setting guide, the correct place for the phone is below and slightly to the left of the bread plate. So what do you think? Should phones be added to the formal place setting? Well, believe it or not, we have Etiquette St. Louis's Melanie here with us this morning. Melanie Broyles.
I'm losing it.
Do you have a reaction?
I am. I'm losing it. Everybody's just trying to push me right off the holiday cliff, right? Okay, so people
please don't jump.
I know. People keep sending me this illustration, and I was tagged in it on Facebook this morning. And my comment is, ugh, put your phones away. Talk to the people at the table. You will be shocked at what you learn about them. Please, for the love of everything, put your phone away. But in an ironic side, we teach children place settings like the fork has four letters and left has four letters. Forks go on the left. Knife, spoon, and right have five letters.
I've actually never heard of that. That is genius.
Knife and spoon go on the right. Phone has five letters. So if you're going to defy everything I've ever taught you or advice I've ever given you, at least put the phone on the right because it has five letters, right?
Oh, I love this. Well, you know, okay, this is probably only the beginning of it because the holiday is in full swing.
Yes.
So, of course, we have to talk about holiday etiquette. We're going to have office parties, family parties, the whole gamut. It's all coming at you, full force.
Meals, the whole thing. And Christmas cards in the mail.
Christmas cards, that's always a big one. You know, the people with the big letters.
Okay, so
are my favorites to read.
So I would tell you that Christmas cards are great. Send them out. If you've changed your address, send them out early so that people get your change of address and they can send one back to the proper address.
Great.
The letters about your kids and your family are fantastic. If you keep it in check. I mean, it comes a point.
Some of those five-page letters, maybe nix those.
Maybe, because nobody's ever going to read the whole thing. But I think the harder thing is tell people how great things are going. Give them a summary of it. But those letters where it says, this kid did this and got this on their report card and got this and did, people start rolling their eyes.
Yes.
I don't, because that would be rude. But people do start rolling their eyes. So make sure you keep that in check. Give people the highlights, but don't overdo it to the point where we're all sitting there saying, there's no way. Right? So
just be
thoughtful in the information you're sharing. Send holiday greetings, Merry Christmas, and then move on.
Okay, I do have to quick admit that I moved and my holiday card is not getting out early. So I'm in the shame corner over here, but I'm going to keep listening because I follow your advice.
Yes.
So what's like the next big thing that people, you know, the biggest offender?
So I think for me it is, bringing a hostess gift is a big deal. We want people to bring a hostess gift
if
you come to a
party. Okay, that's some kind of question. If I go to a party, do I bring a hostess gift?
You always bring something. You always bring,
so if they don't want you to bring food. Like, yes, absolutely.
If they don't want you to bring food or contribute, bring an ornament, bring
okay.
a bottle of wine, but don't have the expectation that they're gonna serve that bottle of wine. Don't bring flowers they have to tend to, that have to be opened and put in a vase because you're adding work to the party hostess. So if you bring wine, bring it for them. Don't bring it chilled. Don't bring it prepared. Be prepared for them to set it aside. They're not going to serve it. It's a gift for them. But always never show up empty handed.
That is such a good reminder. Now, here's a big one. So I have a hair appointment coming up.
Yes.
And I did think about that. And I saw some of these posts floating around the internet to give a holiday gift or tip or not, and I just wanted to do it anyway because I like my hairdresser, but you know, is that the right thing to do?
Yes, so people who help you be you during the year, childcare provider, a regular coach for your children, hair care, nail care, someone that does regular skin stuff for you, someone who tailors clothing for you, double your tip, give them a little extra tip, pay for an extra service, pay for an extra day of childcare. Think of them. Now, there's not an amount. I don't want to set an amount on this. It is up to your budget. Make sure it's whatever you can afford. That might be $10 for you, and it might be something totally different for somebody else. You set your budget, but it is important this time of year that we take care of those who take care of us.
I like that. And just so quickly, thank yous.
Okay, get your kids' thank you notes. Put them in their stockings, give them to them. Teach them, sit down with them. They can be simple with their name, their monogram, but teach your kids to say thank you. They're getting lots of gifts. People are doing lots of things, dropping off food, hosting parties. Say thank you. This would be one of the most meaningful things you can do this Christmas season is make sure your kids learn to say thank you, and then you follow that advice as well. Thank you notes. Say thank you.
I like that. Those should never go out of style. Melanie Broyles here with Etiquette St. Louis.
Thank you.
Thank you as always
for
keeping us grounded,
yes.
especially during the holiday season.
Yes.
We're going to send it over to Kevin with news. Kevin.